Hello guys, welcome to another video. Today we are going to talk about exchange of non-monetary assets. So first we need to understand what is the non-monetary asset. Actually, non-monetary asset refers to an asset that a company holds that does not have a precise dollar value and is not easily convertible to cash or cash equivalent. Okay, so company categorize usually these non-monetary assets as either tangible assets or intangible assets. So here we are talking about exchange. Exchange means to say, for example, you are going to exchange a building with the machinery, or you are going to exchange a car with the building. So this is what is called exchange of non-monetary asset. So first we need to understand when it comes to the accounting. So under US GAAP, first I'm going to explain under US GAAP. So if you want to do the accounting, first all the exchanges must be categorized into one of these two categories. So the first category is what? Those exchanges which will have the commercial substance, their accounting is different. And those exchanges which lack the commercial substance, their accounting will be different. Okay, so we need to understand first here, what is the meaning of commercial substance, having commercial substance. So here we go. So the exchange will have commercial substance. It will have a commercial substance if the future cash flow change as a result of the exchange. Like this exchange is gonna to affect the future cash flows. In other words, if the economic position of the two parties, who is the part of the exchange, if the economic position is going to change, so it means exchange is having a commercial substance. Okay, so that this change could be even in the area of risk, timing, or maybe the amount of cash flows. Okay, so this is what is called commercial substance. So sometimes we also follow the same rule. If you are exchanging building with the car and both asset is having a readily determinable market value, okay, or the market value is determinable, so you can also that can also fall under the category of exchange having the commercial substance. So if due to the exchange, maybe if your cash flows are not going to change, or risk or timing or amount of cash flows is not going to affect, so we will say the exchange lacking the commercial substance. Okay, so but if you are IFRS student, so under IFRS what we do, actually under IFRS we will categorize our exchange into two category. One is called exchange with the similar asset, okay, or the exchanges with the dissimilar asset. Please, you should remember here, so the accounting for, I will explain the accounting for dissimilar assets. Okay, accounting for dissimilar assets, if you are exchanging dissimilar assets, so it is the same as per US GAAP also, because in GAAP that a point is called exchange is having a commercial substance. Okay, so this is what we are going to talk about. So if you are IFRS student, so you should remember, so here we are talking about exchange of dissimilar assets. If you are US GAAP student, you should remember here we are going to talk about exchange of asset which having the commercial substance. Okay, so this is what I'm going to cover today. In the next video we will see what we will discuss. So here we go. You should remember here, whenever the exchange is going to have a commercial substance, okay, so at that time which approach you will use, you will always use fair value approach. Okay, this approach you will use to do the accounting. So what is the fair value approach? So here we have a very important rule. So for example, let me just explain. Let's assume we have a company A. Company A is having a car, and we have a company B. Company is having a, for example, machine. So what we are going to do, we are going to exchange the asset. So what if company A is going to exchange car with the machine? Okay, now it means company A, what we need to do here, for the company A, the asset given is the car, huh? Please don't forget, for the company A, asset given up is the car. Okay, so what is the rule here? If you want to apply fair value approach, okay, what we will do here, the fair value approach of the asset given up is generally used to measure the cost of asset acquired. Like for example here, it's really important rule. So if you want to record, because as a company A, because you are going to give car to the company B and you are going to take the machine, so it means as a company A, what you need to do, you need to record machine. I'm talking about company A point of view. Company A will record the machine, okay, because he's going to receive, and the company A will remove the car from its financial statement. Now the point is that at which value company A will record the machine, at which value? So this is what is the rule. Rule is that we will use the fair value of asset given up. Okay, asset given up. So we will take the fair value of asset given up to measure the cost of asset acquired. Okay, the cost of asset. So here it means our for the company A point of view, asset given up is the car. So we will use the fair value of asset given up, I mean to say the car, to measure the cost of asset acquired, I mean to say the machine. Okay, so please remember. So there is another rule, there is a condition is that unless, so you can use fair value of asset given up unless the fair value of asset received is more clearly evident. Okay, so whatever actually here, so if mostly we will use given up, if the fair value of asset received is more clearly evident, so you can use that one also. Okay, but we should use the fair value of asset given up because it will be given in your exam also, and we will practice the question here. Okay, so here you have a two conditions. Please, you should remember here, sometime when you exchange the asset, okay, so you might pay the boot, or you might receive the boot. Boot mean to say the cash is involved in the transaction, like one party maybe will pay the cash along with the asset also. Okay, so and there might be a transaction without boot mean to say there is no cash involvement in the transaction. So please remember here, if the boot is involved in the transaction, so the cost of asset acquired, I'm talking about, like how you will determine the cost of asset acquired, and I told you rule just above. So the cost of asset acquired will be equal to fair value of asset given up plus cash paid mean to say, for example, if you have a car, I'm just assuming, okay, car market value is $10 only, and the machine market value is, for example, $15. So what you will do, you will give the car plus maybe $5 of the cash. So this is what you are going to do here. So you will take, if you want to measure the cost of asset acquired, you will take fair value of asset given up plus cash paid. Okay, or if you have received the cash, maybe other party is paying to you, so then at that time you will minus the cash received, like you will take fair value of asset given up minus cash received. Okay, but if there is no boot, no cash involvement in the transaction, then your cost of asset acquired is equal to just simply fair value of asset given up, unless the fair value of asset received is more clearly evident. So this you will understand in a better way if we will practice the question, if you will look at the example. So here we go. So here we have one more point. So whenever there is an exchange having the commercial substance, so you have to recognize all gains and losses. So because as per just double entry, if you will look, so you have to debit the new asset. Okay, you have to debit the new asset, whatever you are receiving. So you have to remove the old asset also, which you are exchanging. To remove the old asset, you need to remove the old asset cost and accumulated depreciation. Okay, so old asset cost and accumulated depreciation. To remove the old asset accumulated depreciation, so you will debit the accumulated depreciation of old asset. Okay, and you will credit the cost account of again old asset. Okay, if you have received the cash, you will debit the cash. Okay, you will debit the cash if you have received. If you have paid the cash, you will credit the cash. And still you have to look at the difference. If your entry is not balanced here, so the difference will be gain or loss. And I will show you which exactly components you will use here to measure the cost of new assets. So here I told you, when you want to debit the new assets, so here you have to follow these rules. If there is no boot, so cost of asset acquired is equal to fair value of asset given up plus cash paid or minus cash received. Okay, so if there is no boot, so the cost of asset acquired is equal to fair value of asset given up. So actually these notes are relevant to this debit side. Okay, so now here, but because when you exchange the asset, So one asset you are giving and second asset you are receiving. So you might have a gain or loss on asset given up. And if you want to calculate the gain or loss on asset given up, so simply what you will do, you will take the difference of fair value of asset given up, of asset given up. And you will take the difference with the fair value and book value. Book value means the carrying value of asset given up. Okay. Please don't make mistake here. Don't include cash here, because here you want to calculate simply like a gain or loss, okay, on the removal of assets. So you will take fair value and book value, the difference of fair value and book value. So here we go. Let's practice the question and see how both entries will perform. So here first I'm going to talk about only in the books of the party who is paying the cash. At the end I will include both parties into the transaction. So here let's have a look how we will do the accounting. In the books of the party who is giving the asset plus paying the cash. So here we go. Facts. We have a Foxy company exchange used car. So they are going to exchange used cars for a building. Okay, so like cars we are going to replace with a building that could possibly become Foxy company storage space. The future cash flows will significantly change. It means this exchange is having a commercial substance. The book value of the car's total is 40,000. This is the book value. Don't forget, this is the book value. Book value means a carrying value, because cost of the asset was 102,000 minus accumulated depreciation is 62,000. This is how you got the book value, which is 40,000. Don't forget. Okay. The car's fair value is 45,000. Like the day when you exchange, its market value is 45,000. In addition, Foxy pay $20,000 cash as part of the exchange. So we also paid the cash. And I told you we are doing the accounting first for the party who is paying the boot also. Okay. So then I will talk about from both party point of view. Okay. So here we go. What is the requirement? Requirement is we have to calculate the gain to be recognized on the exchange. Not a double entry. I'm not asking about double entry. Double entry I will pass. Just first we need to calculate the gain. So I told you rule here. When you want to calculate the gain, just you have to take fair value of asset given up and book value of asset given up. Okay, so this is what you have to take. So fair value of asset given up, if you look at the question here, so simply fair value of asset given up is 45,000, which is given here. So I will put it here. Minus book value. Book value is 40,000, which I can calculate this way also. Cost of the car, which is 102,000, less accumulated depreciation, which is 62,000. Both information is given in the question. So just you have, it means book value is 40,000. So we will take this 40,000 here, this one. Okay. And this is your gain. Why? Because your fair value is greater than book value. So that's why you have a gain. So if your fair value is less than book value, okay, so this will be a loss on exchange. And this gain or loss you have to record. Okay. So here we go. Now I'm using the same data. So with other requirements, so here we have a question again. So here we have a Foxy company exchange used cars for building. Same question we have, and future cash flows is significantly is going to change. The book value of car total is 40,000 is the book value, and the market value of asset given up is 45,000, and we paid a $20,000 cash. So now I want you to calculate what the basis for new building and prepare the journal entry which we should record. Okay, basis for new building mean to say I want to calculate the cost of asset received. Cost of asset received. And if you remember, I told you just equation was what? If there's a boot, I will take fair value of asset given up. Okay. Plus cash paid, I told you this equation, minus what cash received. But here we are paying the cash, we are not receiving. So what I will do here, so simply fair value of asset given up. Asset given up is the car, and the fair value of asset of the cars is $45,000. Plus we paid a cash of $20,000. Here it's given in the question. So it means we didn't receive anything. I will put zero here. So it means the cost of building, the basis for the building should be 65,000. So this is with this value you will record the building, like you will dapper the building. Now the point is what entry you will pass. So here we go, guys. First of all, you need to dapper the building. Dapper the building with the 65,000, okay? Because you are receiving the building. And now you have to remove the cars from the your books of account. To remove the cars, we have to remove the carrying value of asset. Carrying value of asset meant to say it's equal to cost minus accumulated depreciation. So we need to remove both now. We need to remove the cost also. To remove the cost, I will credit the cars with the cost, and cost was 102,000. And I will also remove the accumulated depreciation. To remove the accumulated depreciation, I will double the accumulated depreciation by 62,000. It's given in the question. And we know we also paid the cash of 20,000. So I will credit the cash of 20,000. Of course, if you will, now you can also check the difference. If difference is on debit side, it will be a loss on disposal. If it is on credit side, this will be a gain. So here difference is on credit side, and we have a gain of 5,000. And this 5,000, by the way, we just calculated in the first requirement. Okay, so you can just refer to that. So here we have now change in scenario. I hope it is clear. Now here we have a same data of the question. So just we are going to change one scenario. Now the market value of asset given up means the market value of the cars, assume it is 38,000, not a 45,000. Okay, so what will happen here? Now if you want to prepare the cost basis of the new asset, so if you want to calculate the cost of new asset, now in this scenario, what you will do, guys, here, so you have to take fair value of asset given up. Fair value of asset given up, so that is now 38,000. Plus we paid a cash of 20,000. Okay, now your asset will be recorded at which value? 38 plus 20, it will be 58,000. Okay, so this is the cost base of new asset. And now what entry you will pass? In this scenario, you will have a loss automatically. How? Because you will debit the building now with the 58,000, which just we calculated now. And we will double the accumulated depreciation to remove the accumulated depreciation of the cars by 62,000. We will credit the cars with the cost account, which was 102,000. We will credit the cash by 20,000 because we paid a cash. Okay. So now, of course, the difference will be on debit side, and this difference is called loss on disposal of 2,000. Okay. So this is how you will deal with the exchange. Now, just I'm going to add some information. Okay, and we are going to look in both parties' accounts, because here just we discussed in a one party books of accounts. So here we go. So now let's have a look here. We have here accounting entries in both exchange parties' books. Okay, and again, I'm just covering the point now. Exchange is having a commercial substance. Okay, having the commercial substance. So this is what I'm covering here. So here we go. Again, the same rule, the cost of asset received, if you want to calculate the cost of asset acquired. So how you will calculate that one? So of course, we just studied this rule. So if there is a boot, so the cost of asset acquired is equal to fair value of asset given up plus cash paid minus cash received, okay? Or minus cash received. So here, if there is no boot, so the cost of asset acquired is always equal to fair value of asset given up, okay? Unless the value of asset received is more clearly evident. Okay, so this is the same rule I'm going to apply, but now in the both books. Okay, here we go. So we have here two more examples that I will practice with you to make it more clear. So we have here Jayhawk Company and Wildcat Company agree to exchange piece of machineries. Okay, they are going to exchange the machinery. No exception to fair value counting applies. I mean to say, a fair value both asset is determinable. The following information is gathered from the two companies accounts. So here we have a Jayhawk, here we have a Wildcat. So here we have a historical cost of the asset in both books. We have accumulated depreciation 150, 160. We have a carrying amount here 130, 140. And we have a fair value 250 and 275. So now here, I'm assuming there is no boot. So without boot, what entry you will pass under both books of account? So here first we are going to talk about for the Jayhawk entry. Okay, so how you will do it here, guys? So here first Jayhawk will debit the new asset. New asset is the machinery, so we will debit the machinery and equipment. with which value? With the total fair value given up, huh? Fair value given up, because Jay Huck gave this asset and this asset fair value is 250,000. This is the fair value of asset given up. So we will debit the new asset with this value. And now we need to remove the cost and accumulate depreciation. To remove the cost, I will credit the cost of 280,000. You can look at here, credit the cost of 280,000. And I will debit the cumulative depreciation also. I will, here we can see the debit cumulative depreciation, okay, which is balance in account. And now I also, we didn't pay any cash. It means there is no debit credit of cash. So now we have to calculate gain or loss. Gain or loss, you can say that take the difference also, or difference of these three values, this and this and this. Otherwise, you can calculate this way also. Gain or loss, how you will take? You will take the fair value of asset, which is 250,000, minus carrying value of asset, which is 130,000. So this will give you a gain of 120,000 because you have your fair value is more. Okay. So you will credit the gain on exchange. So this is what Jay Huck will do. Now let's have a look what the Wildcat will pass the double entry. So here we go now, guys. Wildcat will debit the new machine with the fair value of given up, and fair value of given up is 275,000. So we'll debit this value, okay? And he will remove the cumulative depreciation. To remove the cumulative depreciation, he will debit the cumulative depreciation here by 160,000. To remove the cost, he will credit the cost by 300,000. We will credit the machine cost by 300,000. And now there is no boot involved, so it means we will not debit or credit the cash. Simply, we need to calculate the gain or loss. Now, gain or loss will be the difference of fair value of asset given up minus carrying value. Fair value is 275 and carrying value is 140. If you will take the difference, the difference will be 135,000. So this is the gain because fair value is more. Okay. Now here we go. We are going to use the same accounting data. Same data, like we have us two companies. We have a Jayhawk company, Wildcat company. The same data is that just we have here now. Jayhawk also pays a boot of 25,000 to Wildcat. Okay. So here, what entry you will pass here? Please remember, don't forget the rule. Rule is that whenever, please, you have to remember, whenever there is a exchange includes the cash. Okay, what you will do? So cost of asset acquired or cost of new asset, how you will determine new asset or asset acquired? You need a fair value of asset given up plus cash paid, if you paid, minus cash received, if you have received. Okay, this is the question, don't forget, huh? So here Jayhawk has paid the cash, so it means Jayhawk will use this equation, fair value of asset given up plus cash paid. Okay. And Wildcat has received the cash. So Wildcat will use fair value of asset given up minus cash received. This is what the Wildcat will do, okay, in the books of Wildcat. And this will happen in the books of Jayhawk, okay? This will happen in the books of Jayhawk, okay? I will just remove this. So now here we go. How you will record here? First of all, under the books of Jayhawk, so fair value of asset given up is 250,000. Plus he paid a cash of 25,000. So total will be 275. So we will debit 275,000. Okay. New asset. And now rest of the things are same. Just you need to remove the accumulated depreciation. To remove the accumulated depreciation, we will debit the accumulated depreciation. You have to remove the cost of asset given up. So we will credit the cost of asset given up by 280,000. We paid a cash also. We will credit the cash of 25,000. And now the difference will be gain or loss. So here we have a gain on credit side. And how we can calculate the gain? By taking the difference of fair value, which is 250, and carrying value, which is 130. So gain will be 120,000 on the credit side. Okay. Now in the books of Wildcat, we will follow this equation. Fair value of asset given up. Here is the fair value of asset given up. 275 minus cash received, which is 25,000. So you are going to record your asset at 250. In short, you can look at here. So you are recording indirectly the fair value of asset received. Huh? This is what is happening actually. So here we go. Pass the entry. I hope you got my point, what I'm saying. So here, what entry you will pass? So you will double the new asset with 250,000. This is how you will get 250,000. And you will debit the cumulative depreciation okay, because you are going to remove your asset which you have given up. So by 160, you will credit the asset cost account by 300,000. Okay, you have received the cash here, so cash will be debited by 25,000, and the difference you will check is it on debit side or credit side. If it is credit side, it's a gain. And here, by the way, gain, how you will calculate the difference of fair value of asset given up minus carrying value of asset given up. This is how you will deal with the exchange of non-monetary asset having the commercial substance. Thank you so much, guys. In the next video, I will talk about exchange of non-monetary asset lacking the commercial substance. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.